did about 10 days ago. We found the surface area for prisms and, let's see, cylinders and what else? We do cones? Yeah, I think we did cones. No, wait, cones is today. I think we just did cylinders for the surface area. So, surface area is the area of all the sides of a polyhedron added together. But we didn't just find the area of each side. How many sides of, does the box have?
Six.
You could find all six areas of this and add them together. But that's not the method we use, because there's another method that works better on every kind of prism. And the method was, we found the area of the bases, and we found the lateral surface area, remember that? Then we added them together. So what would the area of this base be?
30.
6 times 5, 30. So guess what the area of the top base would be?
30.
Does anybody remember how we found lateral surface area?
Times the height.
No.
Perimeter of the
perimeter of the base times the height. Because remember, if you unfold it, it turns into a big rectangle. You can find the area of that side of that rectangle by using the perimeter. Would be like the bottom of the rectangle, and the height would be the height of the rectangle. Anyway, you do perimeter of the base times the height. What's the perimeter? 6 plus 6 plus 5 plus 5. So in this case, that would be 22. And the height is 12.
And what does that equal, lateral bases?
This is the lateral surface area. That means the surface area of all the up and down sides. The two, 30 is the base, or bases are both 30. And the lateral is that. And this, when you add them all together, that gives you all the surfaces combined. That's basically what we did. On a cylinder, we did kind of the same thing, except for the bases are circles, so we had to use pi r squared for the bases. Remember that? And then we used, for the perimeter of the base, since it's a cylinder, you do the circumference times height. It's the same idea, it's just the formula looks a little bit different. It depends on what your shape is, what you're going to plug in for some of these things. But if it's a cylinder, normal cylinder, it's just going to look like that. You guys might want to write that one down for wherever you have a good page of notes if you didn't write it down already. Okay, anyway, that was a review. That's what we just graded. And today we are doing... Today we are doing cones and pyramids. Cones and pyramids. Pretty similar. Do I explain it or do we just jump in? I better explain it. Well, I would have had to explain it as we did it, but probably better take our time on this one. Okay, pyramid, where would the height of that pyramid be at?
Wait, how did you
show it? From the top.
Yeah, it'd be like right there. You guys know what this line would be from here to here? Apothem. If you have a regular polygon, we use the apothem for one half apothem perimeter. Gives you the area of a regular polygon. Okay, here's something new. The prisms don't have this.
Is that on the side of it?
Yes.
Okay.
That is on the side of the triangle, and it's basically the height of one of the triangles. Not the height of the pyramid, that would just be a line straight up, but the side, the slanted side, and they call that the slant height. And they usually represent it with a cursive L. Don't ask me why. I said no.
What does a cursive L look like?
It's been a long...
Okay, so anyway, how many bases does a pyramid have?
One.
So you find the area of the base plus, so the lateral surface area is like the slanted surface area. It's kind of the same thing. You do perimeter times, instead of height though, it's the slant height. You do perimeter times slant height divided by 2. Anybody know why we would divide by 2?
Because of using triangles.
Because, you're right.
The slant height is the height of that triangle.
So. Right.
So it would be like 1.
So if you're so it's kind of like if you're trying to find the area, I think, of that triangle, you would typically do base times height divided
right.
by 2, but since it's three-dimensional, you're doing base plus P perimeter times the slant height.
So this B, some of these formulas don't help as much as others. This B just says whatever the shape of the base is, you got to find the area. That's what the B stands for, base area. Perimeter is the perimeter of the base times slant height divided by 2. We have to divide by 2 because the sides are made up of triangles. Okay, that's pyramids. And the other thing we're doing today is cones. It's kind of similar. How many bases does a cone have? One. And how do we find the area of a circle?
Pi
r squared. So this. Pi r squared would give us the area of the base. A cone also has a slant height. Just go from a point on the bottom straight up to the vertex. And it has a radius. Okay, so pi r squared gives us the area of the base. For the lateral surface area, it's kind of like perimeter. You do circumference times slant height divided by 2. But this is not called the circumference. Perimeter. Perimeter times slant height divided by 2. But the perimeter on the circle is called the circumference. You guys remember the circumference formula? Okay, 2 pi r times slant height divided by 2. This actually simplifies, though. I wouldn't write that down. The times 2 and divide by 2 cancel out. So it's just pi r l is the easier way to do that. Whoops.
Oh, I see what you mean.
That first formula would work, but it's just a little bit more than we need. Pi r squared for the circle, pi r l for the sides. Those are the only two formulas for it. You add the area of the base plus the area of the lateral to get the total area. So this is for pyramids.
And so the pi r squared is not like the surface area.
Pi r l is what you use. It's kind of like this right here, but it's basically what you use to find the lateral surface area. This is that pi r squared is the area of the base, the circle.
Oh, okay. So they're two separate formulas.
Well, it's one formula.
So pi r l is for the lateral surfaces, and pi r squared is for that circle.
For the base.
Is for the base. So
and you add them together, they get you the total.
Okay.
Number one. Are you guys on 417 already? It says segment FE. Do you guys see FE in the picture?
Yeah.
What is that? Side of the base. That is option. Option, B, option 5. So put number 1, A is B. And then segment AF. Do you guys see AF in the picture?
Would that be the lateral edge?
Yeah. AF is a lateral edge. You guys remember edges and vertexes and all that stuff? Lateral edge is option three. Okay, C, it says AG. You guys see AG in the picture. Slant height. See how it's like the height of the triangle on the side? So that's called a slant height, slanted. That's six, yeah. And then 8H. H is going from the top of the pyramid straight down to the ground. So it's the height of the pyramid. So D is 2. E says segment GH. This one's a little bit weird. You guys know what GH is? It's the apothem, right? That can be used to help us find the area of the base. So E is 1. F says segment FH. Okay, yeah, if we drew a circle around the base, FH would be the radius of that circle. So FH is the radius of the pentagon also. Radius is option 4. Okay. Before we do number 3, 2, 3, and 4 are all kind of the same. Do you guys see in that picture, triangle? Actually, let me go back to my picture. Okay. Do you guys see this outline that I made with the blue, with the height, the apothem, and the slant height? What does that create when you combine those? A right triangle. So if we have a right triangle, guess what we're going to be doing? Pythagorean theorem. Yeah, good job. Good guess. So that's what we're going to be doing on number 3. Actually, huh?
Would that
be what? We're using the same picture. Okay. So on number 3, says the height of the pyramid, AG. Okay, we're supposed to find the height of the pyramid. That'd be like this line. If AG is 26, you guys see AG in the picture? It's a slant height, so it looks like that. And HG, that little line at the bottom, is 10. So how do I find the height of the pyramid? You guys see where I got this from? I'm looking at the same picture we just used for number 1.
I see it. I'm just confused.
Okay, it said AG is 26, so that was basically the hypotenuse. You gotta look at, if you're confused, you gotta look at the picture for number 1. Yeah, so how do I solve this for H? The height squared plus 10 squared equals 26 squared. Pythagorean theorem for the 100th time. I don't know what 26 squared is, so you guys might have to help me on this one.
676.
So now what do we do?
You gotta get rid of the square, right?
Square root, to get rid of the square. Square root. Somebody needs to plug that in the calculator. Square root of 576 is? 24.
Good job, Marie. How do you square root?
All right. Number 5. Find the lateral surface area and surface area of each right circular cone. Did we talk, I can't remember, 10 days ago, did we talk about what they meant when they said right? Like a right? It means, basically means it goes straight up. So this, if this were a cone, this would be right, because when I draw the height in, it's at a right angle. If it looked like this, this would not be a right circular cone. It would just be a cone. So if it says right, it just means it's normal, going straight up, like a normal cone. Okay, number five. So, do you guys remember the lateral surface area thing? It was just, it just simplifies to pi r l. Let me show you where that was. It's basically this part right here was the lateral surface area for a cone. This was the base area. So we just need pi r l for the base, for the lateral area. Pi r is 9, the radius is 9, and the slant height is 12, and then the pi, order of multiplication doesn't matter. What's 9 times 12?
24.
Incorrect. 108 pi. I guess this is centimeters. So centimeters squared.
Mr. Jordan, you're doing this to us on the first day back.
Yeah. You guys, does everybody know where I got those? Does everybody know where I got that stuff from?
Yes.
Okay, the formula. The formula I didn't really break it up for us, but I just talked about it. This was the lateral surface area. This is the base area. You add them together to get the total area.
Which one is this?
Which one's the base area?
Pi r squared, area of the circle is the base area. Okay, the next thing it asks is the total surface area. So we need to add the base area to this. How do we find the area of a circular base, a circle?
Pi r squared.
Pi r squared. The radius is 9, so what's 9 squared? 81 times pi, that's the base area. So I'm just going to add that to my lateral surface area. Those are the two answers.
That's number five.
Yeah. Okay, number seven is the same thing, they just did not draw a picture for us. But we're going to do the exact same steps. So, how do I do lateral surface area? Number seven.
Pi r.
Pi r l. So, what's the radius and what's the slant height? 5 and 6, they just tell us. So, it's 5 times 6 times pi. So, it's 35. Okay, and then we need the lateral, or sorry, no, that's the lateral surface area. Then we need the base area to help us find the total. How do I find the area of the base? Circle, pi r squared. So the radius was 5, so I'm going to do 5 squared times pi. 5 times 5, 25 pi. Add that to the lateral surface area, and I get, oh, I didn't label these. This was inches. I'll be a good boy. I'll be a good boy and label them. What did you say? Never say that again.
Even more than I actually was.
So
Okay. Number 9. We are doing the same thing, but now with pyramids. Okay, from the pyramid formula that I gave you earlier, how do we find the lateral surface area? Okay, a lateral surface area comes from, remember on the, when we did the prism at the very beginning, to find the lateral surface area, we did perimeter of the base times the height. So for a pyramid, you do perimeter of the base times the slant height divided by 2. So this gives us the lateral surface area of a pyramid. Okay, when we get to the test, I'm not going to make you memorize these formulas. But if you don't know like what P or L means, you're going to get it wrong. So you do need to understand this. L stands for the slant height. That's this line right here. P means the perimeter of the base. Whoops. Anyways. So on number 9, says it's a regular pyramid, which means the base is regular, which means all the sides of the base are the same. On number 9, what is the perimeter of the base? Or how would I find it? 24 times 4. Does everybody see where you got that?
Mm-hmm.
Number 9. Okay, 24 times 4 is the perimeter. I'll just leave it like that for now. Then I need to do the perimeter times the slant height. What's the slant height on number 9? Just have to look at the picture. 15. So I'll put times 15 for the slant height. And then divide by 2. Okay, yeah, this comes out as 720 millimeters squared.
Wait, is it not base times P times L?
Was that the lateral surface area?
This is the lateral surface area. Okay, what am I missing to find the total surface area? What's missing from this? The base area, the bottom. How do I find the base area if the base is a square? Huh? 24 times 24, base times height. It's a square on the bottom. You just do 24 times 24. Which is, I think we did this one earlier, wasn't it 576? Like this one's on another problem, we did square root of 576 is 24. Anyway, the base area is 576. Add that to the lateral surface area. 1296. S for surface area. L for lateral surface area. Okay, number 11 says find the, okay, we're in the same thing. Oh, I need to help you guys with number 10. On number 10, you want me to do that now or finish the odds?
No.
No. Okay, on number 10 it's harder because on the base they just give us a 7 right there. This is the base of number 10. Yeah.
You can get the height.
Okay, we know it's a regular base, so all those are 7. How can you get the height, Will?
So then that makes a 30, 60, 90, so that will cut that in half, so that the 3.5, so then the height would be 3.5 times square root of 3.
Yeah, yeah, this is a trick we use from problems past. When you draw in the height, it creates a 60-30-90 triangle, which is a special triangle. 3.5 is half of 7, and then to go from the short leg to the long leg, you do 10 squared of 3. Okay, I'm not going to do this whole problem, but how would I find the area of the base?
7 times 3.5 square root of 3. So
close. You did make a little mistake. 7 times 3.5 square root of 3.
Divide by 2.
Divide by 2. Because it's a triangle. On this problem, just my advice is just turn everything into a decimal. Just because it'll be really messy if you don't. So don't leave the square root in your answer. This is not an answer, by the way. What did I just find?
The formula for the answer to the base.
Okay, yes, the area of the base. Okay, but that is not one of the questions. One of the questions is find the lateral surface area, which is perimeter area times length times divided by 2. The second question is find the total surface area. So you have to do the lateral surface area plus the area of the base, which is this, whatever that is. Okay, you guys got it? That's not an answer on number 10, that's just to help you find the answer number 10. The area of the base. Alright, let's try number 11. Number 11 is easier than 10, thankfully. Okay, number 11. We're supposed to find the lateral surface area. How do I find lateral surface area of a pyramid? Just did it on number 9.
Perimeter times
slant height divided by 2. What is the perimeter on number 11? Perimeter of the base on number 11. 5 times 5. 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. 25. That's perimeter. What's the slant height on number 11?
10.
10. Probably do this part in your head. 25 times 10 is 250. Divide by 2. 125 inches squared. Okay, that's a slant height. What am I missing?
The base.
The base. How do we find the area of this pentagon? Oops.
You need the popping.
Right. And which they tell us on this one is 3.4. So do you guys remember this formula?
1/2
Yeah, 1/2 popping times perimeter. So.
Oh.
Instead of 1/2, I'll just put in 0.5 times the apothem. Remember the perimeter from earlier was 25. I don't think I can do that by hand. It's too much.
No, that's
25 plus.
Twenty-five
plus 42.5 gives us the total 167.5.
And then formula, so I pretty much multiply the Poplin by one the size, divide by two, then multiply it by the number of sides.
How do you find the base? What's the formula for base on the just the
It depends on what the base is. Like if it's a square number 9, we just multiply the sides of the square. On number 11, we just multiply the times square root. That's why it just is a B, because there's too many options. Okay. Number 13. A slant height of 12 meters. This is, we're still in the pyramid section. So the pyramid has a slant height of 12 meters and a nonagonal base. What's a nonagonal? Nine sides. Sounds kind of like nine, right? Nonagon. I'm not going to try to draw a nonagon. I'll just pretend there's a nonagon right there. And it says there's 1 meter on each side of the nonagon. So,
easy.
Yeah. Perimeter times slant height divided by two. You guys remember? What is the perimeter of the nonagon on the base?
Nine.
One times nine, basically. What's the slant height?
12.
Girls, you're about to split up. 12, and divide that by two.
54.
Okay. That's the, the lateral surface area. Okay, plus we need to find the total surface area, we need the area of the base. They told us the apothem was 1.4.
It's 1.4.
So remember we're doing 1/2 times apothem times perimeter for the area of the base.
1.4 times 9 divided by 2. 4 times 0.5.
Yeah, so the perimeter is still 9, just like before. Yeah, you can divide by 2 instead of multiplying by 1/2. I think that would be 6.3. This right here.
Yeah.
So then we've got 60.3 meters. In total. So guys, here's my advice. Maybe I should have started with this, but darn it, where did it go? On your formulas, you might just like label the parts as lateral surface area. Okay, on number two, okay, you need help setting up number two?
Sure.
Okay, number two says the slant height is what we're trying to find. If HG is 24, do you guys see HG in the picture?
The poppy?
Yes. You see HG in the picture.
Yeah.
So where should it go on my little picture right here? Where should 24 go?
Right there.
At the base.
On the bottom. Yeah.
Oh.
HG is that little line on the bottom of the triangle. You guys see it? Okay, and then it says AH is 18. You guys see AH?
Yeah, that's from the top to the bottom.
Oh, right. I forgot about the
right?
Yeah.
That's this one right here. So, we're looking for the slant height, which is like hypotenuse. So, Montana, you know how we set this one up?
I get it.
Why not?
So, there's 9.
Probably because I write like this and you're like,
perimeter times. Okay, so it's perimeter times. Okay, yeah. So it's.